Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. I hope you're all well. Today you're joining me at Suzuka Circuit in Japan, and I'm in the URD JT5 car. It's a paid mod. Effectively, it's the Nissan Super GT car from 2016. We're going to do six laps here, 16 cars on the grid, and I'm starting in eighth position. Let's see how we go. I haven't taken one of these off the line yet, so I don't know how they go. Just been doing some practice laps. Oh, that's a jostling. Wow. Good contact there. Lost two spots straight off the... Three spots. Right. Let's get these back. As you can see, they're a little bit understeery on entry and then a little bit oversteery on exit. A bit of tow, a bit of brake to get the nose to turn in. Oh, we've got cars off. He's just re-entering as he likes. Oh. Got that curve there. That's all the way out. Nope. So yeah, Suzuka might be familiar to you guys if you watch. I've driven it, but if you watch Formula 1 obviously, it's a very technical circuit. Short shifters, the cars will slip into the wall. And typically the Super GT series, they run at around 3 now on the calendar. The Super GTs used to be big V8s. Not big, sorry, 3.4 litre V8s, but now they're, I believe they're 2 litre turbos. I think they're still putting around 550 horsepower, something like that. So they're meant for cars still. Locked off here, back on the gas. Coming up to the last chicane. A short shift out of here, because the car just wants to end you. Off balance, off camera corner here.
The lap is a 2:02.91.
So the Super GT series don't run ABS or traction control, so I'm not running it in this race either. So no aids. It wants to end you all the time. There's in there. This mod sounds awesome, as you can all hear. Absolutely brilliant. So yeah, I said it was a paid mod. I'll, if anyone's interested, I'll leave a link in the description for it. It was only €3.99, so it equates to about $1,000. I guess this is really what the Studio 307 GT500 car would be if it was updated. Very engaging car. I actually prefer this one to the original. It's got a nice model, it's got great sounds, and most importantly it's very engaging, the physics are great. And this car and the track are a perfect combination. Brilliant circuit and car combination. These cars are insane. Yes, yes. Okay, up to fifth. Urge anybody, if they like engaging drives, which is, you know, in my opinion, what sim racing should be, then give this combo a go, if you haven't already. Tyre's just squealing away there. Should be able to catch this guy coming. No, he shut the door on me. Got past.
156.43.
Catch up with these guys in the middle. Oh, if I run that wide. Yes, come on. Again, I'm gonna blame the tyres. Can I make this ground up? Seconds on. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. This guy just wants to bite you every chance it gets. This car feels so much more alive to me than the original GT500 car. Wow, the miles Last lap, I don't think I'm going to be able to catch him. It's a shame. Texture, the rubber's actually starting to build up a bit now too, which maybe not. Which is making for some quicker time, probably could have caught me. A couple more laps. Into the hairpin for the last time. Double left-hander. Out wide. Ooh. Silly mistake. Across the line we go. Oof. 8 to 4th, not too bad. Especially in this circuit with this this insane car. I think we did pretty well there. I enjoyed that heap, so I hope you guys did. If you did, give it a like, hit the subscribe button, ring the bell, and I'll be sure to upload some more content soon. Thanks everyone. Bye.